Hello friends, Satyendra here, and in this video, let's understand variable section sweep in Creo Parametric. So let's get started. Now the variable section sweep is similar to sweep. The only difference here is you allow section to change. So earlier Creo Parametric was having two different options for sweep and for variable section sweep. Now it got merged as a single option. So here in variable section sweep, everything is similar as sweep. The only difference you see is the multiple path. So the first path you select, the section moves normal to that path, and other paths are used as a guide rail. So let's design this part to understand variable section sweep and to see what difference it brings. And to start it, first you go to new, part, solid, assign the name and say OK. So I'll start this path with this base, and for this I'll go to extrude onto the top datum plane, normal, switch off the datums. Now draw the center line first, just like this, then a rectangle, make it symmetry. So the rectangle is 150 by 100, so I'll make it 150 by 100. So this I'll make it 150 and this 100, say OK. Now the thickness is 25, say OK, Control D. Now the next feature is this feature, and for this once again go to extrude onto the right datum plane, normal. Draw the circle somewhere here. Now this is 135. And from here till here, this is 30. Now this dimension is dia 48. Say OK. Now the total length is 65. Make it symmetry and say OK. Control D. Now the next feature is this feature, which is done using variable section sweep. So for that we need to draw the path first. So go to the sketch onto the right datum plane and say sketch, normal. Now go to the reference first and create the reference like this, this and this. Now draw the path. So I start with a line from here this side, then an arc from here to the tangent of this reference. Go to delete segment and delete this unwanted segment. Now this is radius 50, so make it 50. Now one more path, and for that I'll use arc. I'll start from here, I'll go to this and I'll place like this. Now this is radius 137. And the gap between this and this is 80. This is 137. And your sketch is done. Say OK. Control D. Now let's try the variable section sweep. And for that go to sweep. First you select that path through which the section has to be normal. So this is the path, flip the start point, then press and hold Control key and select the second path. So in variable section sweep, you can have n number of paths. If the feature is possible, then it will generate. Otherwise, sometime you get some error. So once this is done, go to sketch, normal. Now here I'll draw one ellipse, end to end ellipse. So I'll start from here, go till here and place like this. Now this gap is 40 and say OK. So this is how you get the result. Now one thing you understand that when you have one section and one path, then you go for normal sweep. When you have one section with a multiple path, then you go for variable section sweep. And when you have multiple sections without any path, then you go for blend. And when you have multiple sections with one path, then you go for swept blend. So here in this case, I was having one section with two paths. So the option was very clear that I can only go with variable section sweep. And that is why I used variable section sweep here. So all add material features are done. Now I'll go for remove material feature. So I'll go for extrude. Select this face, normal. Draw the circle. This is dia 25, say OK, flip the direction, make it 2 next and say OK. Next feature is this counter bore hole, which is M10. So for this, go to hole, select this surface, drag this handle to this surface and this handle to this surface. This is 15 and this is also 15. Now go to standard and select M10 here. So this is my M10. Now once this is selected, go for counter bore and then you go for shape. Now here you have this counter bore dia which is 17.5. which is matching with this dimension, so I will leave as it is. Next thing is, you see this counter bore hole throughout. So for this, you make it throughout, then you see the thread throughout, then make it through thread and your hole is done. Now say OK. Now go for pattern and you have this dimension 120 and 70 to get the pattern. So for this, you can either go for direction pattern or point pattern. So let's try point pattern this time. I'll go to reference, define, I'll select this surface and I'll say sketch. So here you sketch the datum point. Now sketch the datum point, place one point here and one point here. Now the dimension, so this is 120. And this is 70. Now the sketch is done, say OK and say OK. Now the next feature is couple of rounds, so go for round, select this edge and this edge and this edge. Now this is 5.75, say OK. Now the next round, which is this edge, this is 5, press and hold control key and select this edge, say OK. Now the next round, which is this edge, press and hold control key and select other edges. Now this is radius 15, so make it 15. And say OK. Now you can hide this sketch and your part is done. So one thing you always remember that these options are advanced options. So if the same feature can be done by extrude, revolve or sweep, then we always avoid these advanced options. But here if you see this feature cannot be done by extrude, revolve or sweep, and that is why you have to have the variable section sweep. So this was the variable section sweep in Creo Parametric and I hope this video will be helpful. Now you can like this video if you find this video helpful and I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.